So here we are. I am really very happy to announce that a very familiar face to all students who basically come to my YouTube channel, Mr. Gulzar Ahmed, has cleared risk management professional with all above done. And what a journey this guy had. I really like, he's a person I really look forward to. He's working in Saudi Arabia. And he's actually trying to give exam by December, but he was unable to get date. Then finally, at the end of January, he found that date in April. And I was not actually in favor of that date. Why? He was very well prepared in the first week of January, but the dates are not available because of COVID or all those things. So finally he said, "Sir, let's take a date." He took a date. He kept on working, he kept on working, and he nailed it. He nailed the best possible way. He became a risk management professional. So let's talk him about his journey of risk management. First of all, Gulzar, congratulations again. And why don't
Thank
you
you very much, sir. Thank you very much, sir. All the tributes of this success, all five above targets, all goes to you. Salute to you, sir, for your efforts, for your dedication. And whenever we needed your help, you were always there. Even the last minutes of the exam, I know that you were the whole night you were giving the coaching classes, but before I wake up, I saw the message, Gulzar, how many hours are there in starting your exam? And I know it was the message was 1 hour before.
Okay.
So the beautiful thing, which I want to admire, and that is really on the best merits, Sir Amir Ali, if he would not be there, these five targets were not possible at all. Because everyone, most of my friends, even sir, says that Gulzar is risk-averse guy. I would have never the courage to take the exam until and unless Sir Amir was there. Thanks God, I have Sir Amir with me, and I did it very well. And thanks God, this was my dream to get five above targets in PMI exam, and it is done now. Thank you very much, sir, again for this.
Happy to help him. And even I was like actually against of his dream. I was saying like getting pass in the exam is the goal. No one actually asked how many above target you get, but he was focused there. Like I would give a lot of credit to Gulzar for this. He was so focused. No, sir, I want all above target and not just like getting three above target in some and two. No, above target, above target, above target, above target, above target in all five domains. His goal was very clear, and he did a lot of mocks. He did Allah Sultan mocks, and they were very good. I really recommend everyone who is going to do RMP that do Allah Sultan mock. They are very good. Then he did my mock on RMP. Then he did some other mocks on RMP.
Simply learn mocks from you, sir. PM
So
trick mocks.
actually, he was prepared by the end of January. So he had 2 months. So whatever he found, he kept on going. I still remember whenever I had a coaching call on risk, he used to say that whenever there is a coaching call of risk, just let me know, I'll join. So he used to join. He's basically my co-facilitator in PMP. He's PMP certified and RMP certified. He's a very motivated guy. Most of the time, the free things I'm giving to people, like right now, we are giving free coaching to everyone who is going to give exam by 18th. That's their idea. He's the guy who pushes me or actually forced me to do, like, sir, let's make this coaching call for everyone or let's do this. He's a, like, there's.
And you are so nice, and you are so benefactor that you are always accepting my request. Thanks to you, sir. Thanks to you.
So he's always there. He's always there. Thank you, Gulzar. Okay, Gulzar, why don't you tell us a little bit more about exam for the context of exam? So exam was 3 or 30 minutes.
Yes, sir. It was totally 4 hours, so we can say 2 hours 40 minutes totally. But the first 30 minutes, they were for, check-in process. And you know, this is only prometric center based exam. When we entered there, we were asked to come before 9 o'clock, half hour before. But you know, this center is taking only there have only 10 seats available for the exam takers. But due to COVID, they were taking only 5 guys, one space vacant, and the alternate they were the candidate was there. So we were only 5 guys, and I was the only risk guy. All others were doing Aramco CBT exams. So I wanted someone to be there discussing with me in RFP, but unluckily I could not find anyone. However, we went there, and I wanted to be the first of all so that I can start the exam, because you know, 9 o'clock we started this check-in process. There was they have taken the photos, they have checked our passport, they verified it. They asked us to put our things in the separate wallet and gave the key, and we went into the center. Then the exam started. There were some instructions. We have read it in 10 minutes. After that, there was a window appear that you want to start the exam, and we click, yes, I want to start. I have clear instructions from you to take the break after 50 questions, and the clock will be ticking, but don't care. And I followed the instructions. After first 50, I took a break for 3 minutes. After second 50, when I was after 100 questions, I took another break for 3 minutes. And thanks to God, the questions were familiar to me. As you know, almost I have done 2,200 questions of risk management. And as you know, I have repeated them many a time. And so the questions, whatever the question was coming, I was perceiving like I'm doing some mock in my office. So I was not at all worried, or there was not at all any stress. Even when the 50 questions finished, I have just followed you religiously. I was not feeling the need to go for the break. But after 50 questions, I went there. I took some dates, took the water, and then came back. And yeah, very interesting thing, sir. I was self-evaluating. After 30 questions, I was evaluating that how many I would have done wrong. I was thinking maybe 2 questions were wrong after 30 questions. And after 50 questions, I was having maybe 4 now. Then after 100 questions, it raised to maybe 10. And 150 questions, it was something 15. This was my calculation. I don't know how true it was or how true it is, in fact. But it was my calculation. I was evaluating myself also. Because the questions, as you know, this risk can be improved. Risk management can be improved through practice. Similarly, the exam for the risk management can be improved through practice. How much you practice this, even the same mocks, some people will be having the perception that a repetition of doing the mocks is useless. But I think that if you are repeating after some interval and focusing what were the mistakes done during the mock performance, that helped a lot. And the beautiful thing in the PM trick exam was there were kill mistake exam also. Means you have done process-wise questions, and you did 20 or 25 questions, and then the kill mistake exam will be having the same 25 questions. So it helps to improve your mistakes, whatever I have done in PM trick. And it was really beautiful journey, and fantastic and very convenient was taking the exam in the Prometric Center. I was really thankful to PMI and Pearson View. They have really good arrangements. They were totally hassle-free. And you know, while we were taking the PMP exam sitting at home, we were having too many threats, too many risks that maybe the electricity will be shut down, maybe internet will be disconnected, or maybe some due to rush, some breakdown of the website can occur, a website can crash. But there was no such a risk, and we were totally risk-free over there, only focusing on the exam. And it was really fantastic to do. And the best thing was when I have finished 170 questions, clicked, I got the message, congratulations. Though I was not that much surprised, because I was expecting that inshallah it will be. And the beautiful thing is that all your coaching was there. All the confidence we have got built from through your mentorship, and it was like a mock test I have done. Thanks to you, sir, again for this mentorship.
Thank you, Gulzar. Thank you for such an elaborative way how you explained. And yeah, those breaks are very important. Although sometimes we feel that we don't need them, but what actually happens? Let me tell you. What actually happens if you don't take break, your mind stop working that way. With the passage of time, so your efficiency decreases. When you take a break, you get refreshed and you get rejuvenated. That is very important in my opinion. Other people may have their own perception. So for my students, I do what I think is best. Okay, for example,
yes, of course, sir.
Yeah, even today, even today when I give exam, like I give ACP, they were not allowing the break, but I took the break. I forced them, I need a break. And that was interesting. It was only 120 question. I took a break after doing 120 question. I was in the flow of, I did 120 question in 1 hour or I think 2 hours, I don't remember. So then I asked them, said no break. I said, I have to take a break or give me in writing. They gave the break. I went to the washroom, drink of water, came back, reviewed the one question, two question, then end my exam. I don't like to review.
Right, sir. I have not reviewed, sir. I have only marked one question.
I'm actually against reviewing the question. If you are sure about your answer the first time and you put it, don't review the question unless you are not sure, unless you are 20% sure. Like I learned this technique, 10%, 20%, 50%, 80%, 100%. 10% means like I'm 10% sure my answer is okay. 20%, like on the mark questions, you have a sheet. I actually do that. On the sheet you have, I write 10%, 20, 50, 80, 100. So how much sure I am about those mark questions? I only read with those questions, but actually I just put tukka or for a chance. Otherwise, I don't review question. If you review question, you put it, even you had something thinking, you were in flow, you can damage the question. And I don't do that. Okay. Thank you very much for this. And I hope now you are relaxed and take some days off to relax. Maybe enjoy the Ramadan, the relaxing mode. You have been pretty tense in last 2 weeks. Let me tell this to everyone. 2 days before exam or 36 hours before exam, Gulzar's eyes were not okay. Continuously using laptop, his eyes actually got swelled. So I asked him not to do anymore. I said, enough is enough.
Yes, sir. That's true, sir.
Because now you need to relax. So all well, that ends well, and it ended very well. Thank you, Gulzar. Be proud again.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you.
Anand just cleared PMP like 10 minutes ago. Ali have cleared PMP with above target. Congratulations, Raheel, on clearing your PMP in first attempt. You cleared PMP exam with 5 above target. The best thing that anyone can do. 5 above target. Ladies and gentlemen, second student in 3 days, 5 above target.
I didn't expect that I will get this result. I thought that I will be like target or like above target.
Thanks to you. Without your dedication and gallants, it was impossible for me.
Above target, above target, above target, above target. Do I have to write some book? Do I have said no? Like whenever he heard, like this guy have read 5 times from book, so many times, you always get confused and come back to me. I kept on saying him, you are going to clear, just read one time. And that's what he did.